Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing parabola and this is the video lecture number 6. I hope you have watched already part 1 through part 5 before watching part 6. We are discussing formation of equation of parabola depending upon the different conditions. In last video, we have discussed few questions where the directrix is given and focus is given. Today, we are going to discuss some more ideas to derive the equation of parabola and some more conditions which can be given to find the equation of parabola. So let me start with few questions and find the equation of parabola which focus is 0, 4 and directrix edge. Directrix edge and vertex edge and vertex edge at minus 1, 3. Minus 1, 3. Vertex is at minus 1, 3 or even we can write minus 4, 6. Minus 4, 6. This is a vertex and this is a focus. Vertex and focus is given. Nothing else. Just two characteristics is given. One is focus, another is vertex. It was odd. I had made it even so that it can be midpoint can be easily derived and it will not come in fraction. Right? So that is why I did it like this. After making odd, we make even. You know that every time I frame the question from myself, no books and nothing material is being referred. So we can change questions and generate questions immediately in any moment and instant of time. So here, find the equation of parabola which focus is at 0, 4 and directrix and vertex is at minus 4, 6. Now think about that. Although there is no need to use and draw proper diagram of parabola, but we can do that. Here, if I am saying this is 0 and 4 is the what focus and vertex is minus 4 and 6, minus 4 and 6, x is minus 4 and y is 6. So this will be like here. This is a vertex. Parabola is like this. You know, this is a vertex. And this is a focus. So of course, parabola will be like this. Parabola will be like this. And right? This is not isoproper. And say this is a vertex. Okay. Minus 4, 6. That can be vertex. So here is a vertex, right? Like this, and that will be the axis of parabola. Here, minus 4 and 6 is the vertex, and this is the axis of parabola. Axis of parabola, line joining axis of vertex and focus is the axis of parabola. So, that can be like this. Let me make this first one for a small one. Bit smaller as compared to the previous one, like this, and this is a directrix, here is the focus, and this is a vertex, x axis, y axis, we don't know where it is. This is 0, 4, this is the focus, this is the vertex, which is given minus 4 and 6, and this is a directrix, we don't know what about directrix. So, this is a parabola. Y axis, x axis, as compared, we have drawn this 0, 4, 4 minus 6 is the vertex, and line joining from vertex to the focus is a axis of parabola. So, first we need to draw the equation of directrix because we know the parabola can be derived by the relation PS is equal to PM, and PM is what? Foot of perpendicular from P to directrix. So we know the equation of directrix. We have to find the equation of directrix. And nothing, the description is given about directrix. So how you can draw the equation of directrix? First we should know, and we know already, why you should know? We know already that this is a midpoint of these two points. Say this is a point K, right? Or A, you know? So V is midpoint of A and S. And A coordinate of A is not known, say H, P. voltage comma phase coordinate of A. So since V is solution, since V is midpoint of A and S, right? So what will be the using midpoint formula? Coordinate of h plus 0 by 2 is equal to minus 4. So what will be h? Minus it. k plus 4 divided by 2 is equal to 6. So k is equal to 6 to 12 minus 4 is 8. Right? So k is 8. H is minus it. And k is 8. This is a point of intersection. Here this point is minus 8 and 8. X is minus 8 and Y is 8. So minus 8 at the end, this is a point. Now these two are always perpendicular. Directrix is always perpendicular to the axis of parabola. You know that? So we can find the slope of this line. Slope of line axis of parabola. Axis of parabola is what? You know, m1 is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So we can write 6 minus 4 y2 minus y1 upon minus 4 minus 0. That is 2 upon minus 4, which is minus 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2. So slope of directrix is m2, directrix is m2, then m1 m2 must be equal to minus 1 because both of them are perpendicular, and therefore this employee m2 is equal to what? M1 is minus 1 by 2 into m2 is equal to minus 1, so m2 must be equal to 2. M2 is equal to 2. Now slope of directrix is known, that is 2. And one point through which this directrix passes, that is also given. So equation of directrix can be derived easily. Now equation of directrix is what? Equation by using one point form, y minus y1, that is 8, is equal to slope x minus x1, minus minus 8, that would be plus 8. So that will come y minus 8 is equal to 2x plus 16, or we can write 2x minus y plus 24 is equal to 0. This is the equation of directrix. Now we have to use the relation. What is that relation? P x1 y1 be any point on the ellipse. I can write here P x1 y1 be any point on the ellipse. So distance is PS is equal to PM, that we have to define. So PS is equal to PM, using PS is equal to PM, or PS square is equal to PM square, you can write here. So PS square is equal to PM square. We can use this. What is the distance? PS is equal to x1 square plus y1 minus 4 whole square, you know. And PM is what? PM is 2x1 plus minus y1 plus 24 upon under root 5 whole square. Under root 5, and this is whole square. That you need to calculate. We have did this, and I hope you know this, how this comes. Ax1 plus by1 plus c upon under root a square plus b square. This is what we did. So here, using this fact, what will happen? Squaring both the sides. We can do that. On squaring both the sides, what will come? Squaring both the sides, x1 square, 5, root 5 will come 5. So this will be 5 times of, and that 5 will come this side. So 5 times of x1 square plus y1 square minus 8y1 plus 16, you know, and that is equal to 4x1 square plus y1 square plus 576 plus 48, 24 to the 48 to the 96, 96 x1 and then 48 y1 and then 2 to the 4, 4 x1 y1, you know, and that will come. A square plus B square plus C square plus 2AB plus 2BC plus 2CA, like this. This will come. Now, we have to go ahead. So let me rub some points here. And we can write from here only. This can be written as 5x1 square plus 5y1 square minus 8 5 40y1 plus 16 5 80 is equal to 4x1 square plus y1 square plus 576 plus 96x1 minus 48y1 and minus 4x1 y1. Now using all this together, this will come this side, x1 square plus 4y1 square, and this will come this side, so it will be plus 4x1 y1 minus 96x1. There is no x1 this side, but y1 is there. So minus 96x1, now 48y1 will make it 8y1, and this is 80 minus 576 will be 496. 496. So this is 496. 496 is equal to 0. That what will come. Now locus of x, px1 y1 is x1 y1 is what? We will write here x square plus 4y square plus 4xy minus 96x plus 8y minus 496 is equal to 0. And this is the equation of parabola. This is the equation of parabola. Just to develop the basic concept, I am doing all these questions, you know. This is a big questions, but just to develop the concept, we have to do this and we need to understand this. This is the equation of parabola under the given circumstances, right? So here x square, you can also verify here what we have learned about. What is a here? A is 1. What is b here? B is 4. So what is ab? Ab is 4. What is h? Half of coefficient of xy, that is 2. So h square is also equal to 4. So h square must be equal to ab. If you will find the determinant of this, that is delta, it will come not equal to 0. So I hope you got this. And if you understood this, then there is no problem. Otherwise, you do it once again. Right? Watch this video again and then definitely you will be able to get it. So parabola can be drawn with the different circumstances, different characteristics can be given. Here we did the questions where the focus and vertex is given. Earlier we did the question where directrix and focus is given. Also, we can draw some other conditions and on the basis of that equation of parabola can be drawn. So let me finish some more question. Find the equation of parabola which directrix is x plus y plus 1 is equal to 1 and vertex is two comma one, like this. This is given. Here, directrix is given, vertex of parabola is given, but no focus, nothing. So here, obviously, we have to draw focus of parabola. So first, we need to find out the focus of parabola, and thereafter, we can use this relationship. PS is equal to PM. So directrix is x plus y is equal to 1. No need to draw a diagram. I am just writing here this diagram, x plus y is equal to 1. This is the directrix, and vertex is somewhere 2 comma 1. x is 2, y is 1. So here 2 comma 2 will lie on this line. X is plus y is equal to 1. This is 1, you know. This is 1 comma 0. And this is 0 comma 1. We just wanted to know the idea, just taking the idea that where is the vertex. So x2 and y1 will be point somewhere else. It is y1 and x2 will be some point here. And here is the vertex. Now, vertex is there. This is the directrix. So parabolas cannot be like this because parabola cannot intersect the directrix. So of course, the parabola will be like this. Right? And here is the point of intersection of this directrix and directrix. So focus is somewhere like this. Focus is this. Vertex is this. That is 2 comma 1 is vertex. And directrix is this one. We have to find first the focus. How can you find the focus? Now this is the line x plus y is equal to 1. X plus y is equal to 1 and axis of parabola is always perpendicular to directrix. So any line, let me write here solution. Since x plus y is equal to 1 is equation of directrix. Equation of directrix. So any line perpendicular to it, any line perpendicular to it, perpendicular to directrix, directrix will have equation x minus y or y minus x, because slope will change, na? X minus y plus k is equal to 0. But this line, so axis of, this is the, so axis of parabola is this, axis of parabola is like this, x minus y plus k is equal to 0. But since it passes through 2 comma 1, since it passes through 2 comma 1, passes through 2 comma 1, hence it will satisfy the equation. Hence it will satisfy the equation. Satisfy the equation. Hence it will satisfy the equation and therefore it will pass it through 2 comma 1. Put x is equal to 2 minus 1 plus k is equal to 0. So k is itself what? K is 1 plus k is equal to 0. K is minus 1. And therefore axis of parabola is, axis of parabola will be x minus y minus 1 is equal to 0. Right? X minus y minus 1 is equal to 0. Now solving these two equations. This equation is x plus y minus 1 is equal to 0. This equation is x minus y minus 1 is equal to 0. Solving this two, we will find the point of intersection, that is say A. Right? So solving this two, we will get the point of intersection. So how to solve this? Solving. On solving x plus y minus 1 is equal to 0 and x minus y minus 1 is equal to 0. Adding these two, y cancel, 2x minus 2 is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, and putting x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0. So point of intersection, if you put x is equal to 1 anywhere, y is equal to 0. So 1 comma 0 is the point of intersection. X1 and y0 is the point of intersection of these two. That is, it might be intersected like this. So this is a, you know, now the correct figure will come here, yeah? And this is the point of intersection. So parabola will be like this. Exact now graph will be like this. Parabola will be like this. And this is the axis of parabola. This is 2 comma 1. Focus is at 2 comma 1. And this is the vertex was given, na? Vertex was given as 2 comma 1. So this is the vertex, that is 2 comma 1 is given. And now there will be focus. This is a parabola. this is a point of intersection of these two. And focus will be what? Now, the focus is this vertex edge, midpoint of this and this, say this point is A. So, coordinate of this can be derived. Let the focus edge consider to be H, K. So, what will happen? H plus X1 plus X2 by 2 is equal to X coordinate, right? Midpoint formula, X1 plus X2 by 2. H plus 1 by 2 is equal to 2, and therefore H is equal to 4 minus 1, 3. Also, K plus 0, K plus 0 by 2 is equal to Y coordinate, that is 1. So, it will be what? K is equal to 2. So, focus is now come to 3, 2. Focus will come like 3, 2, in fact. Now, using the basic one now, where, what is that? X1, Y1. A is any point, so distance from this S to the PM, H, same. And what is, we can use this. I hope you got this. First, what we did it? First equation of directrix was given. We have drawn the equation of axis of parabola. And therefore, after finding the equation of axis of parabola, because this is a perpendicular, so slope can be determined. And slope is determined, and one point through which it is passes, so easily equation can be derived. Now, after solving these two, we will find the point of intersection of axis of parabola and directrix, and thereafter, using midpoint formula, we can find the focus of parabola. Now, use the same thing. This is the primary question work which I did here, and now you have to use this basic one, that is PS is equal to PM. Again, now using PS is equal to PM. Using this fact, PS is equal to PM, what will happen? PS is under root, what? X1 minus 3 whole square, X1 minus 3 whole square, Y1 minus 2 whole square, and Y1 minus 2 whole square, that is PS. And PM is what? X1 plus Y1 plus 1 upon under root 1 square plus 1 square whole modulus. So what will happen? This you need to explain. What will happen then thereafter? So it will be squaring both the sides. Squaring both the sides, what will come? Now this will come X1 square minus 6x1 plus 9 plus y1 square minus 4y1 plus 4 is equal to x1 square plus y1 square plus 2x1 plus 2y1 plus 1, right, plus 2x1y1, and divided by under root 2. So after squaring it will be 2. So 2 will come this side, it will be 2x1 square plus 2y1 square minus 12x1 minus 8y1 plus 26, 9 plus 4, 13, 13 to just 26. X1 square plus y1 square plus 2x1 y1 plus 2x1 plus 2y1 plus 1, like this. So after drawing the same here in this side, 2x1 square minus x1 square, what will come? X1 square. 2y1 square minus y1 square, y1 square. 2x1, y1, this side will come 2x1, y1, negative. Minus 12x1 and 2x1 will come this side, it will be also negative. So minus 14x1. 8y1, 2y1 will come this side, it will be also negative. So 10y1. Plus 1 will come this side, it will be negative. So 26 minus 1 is 25. Now, locus of px1 y1 is what? X square plus y square minus 2xy minus 14x minus 10y plus 25 is equal to 0 is the equation of parabola. Is the equation of parabola. Right? So this is what? Equation of parabola that can be derived. So depending upon the condition, there are only 3-4 things that either directrix will give in and focus will give in, directrix can be given, vertex can be given, or focus can be given and vertex can be given. Depending upon these circumstances, we can find, derive the equation of parabola. Sometimes directrix is not given, but axis of parabola is given and vertex is given. On the basis of that, we can also derive the equation of directrix and derive the equation of parabola. But all these, once you understand this phenomena, complete phenomena of all these, then definitely you will be able to analyze this. What the basic is? Basic is that depending upon definition, it all included in definition that TS must be equal to PM. And depending upon that definition, we have to do this, that TS is equal to PM. But for this, the directrix is required and focus is required. If these two are directly given, you can apply this. If these two are not given, some other actually item is given, you have to find these two first, and thereafter you need to evaluate this and proceed this. I hope you got it. And no need to draw this. You can draw a rough sketch of this also, because this is a parabola, say like this. This is a parabola, vertex is this. 2, 1. No need to write like this complete diagram. Exact diagram is not required. And directrix is somewhere like this. What is that? X plus y is equal to 0. So axis of parabola, this is perpendicular. So it must be x minus y and plus k. But because it is passing through this, what will happen? But value of 2 and 1. So 2 plus minus 1 is 1. K is equal to minus 1. So put here k is equal to minus 1. Now you can find this. This is the focus and point of intersection is 1, 0. So we can solve them, and using this we can find this 3, 2. And now go for PS equal to PM. Use the same pad. Here no need to draw the exact diagram. Don't be puzzled about this diagram, that exact diagram is needed. Here you can do the same. PS equal to PM, wherever it is, it hardly matters for you. You have to go with this condition that PS is equal to PM. And once you will derive this, you will be able the same result. Whether this in this equation PS is equal to PM or in this equation PS is equal to PM is the same thing. So a check diagram is not required. Don't try to draw this, because it will make something puzzle to you. But here the concept is that anywhere you can write the line, line is not exactly required to write here, and you will be able to derive the equations without exact diagram. You can just stick as per your convenience concept like this, and you can proceed for deriving the equation of parabola. So hopefully you got all these points and how to derive the equation of parabola. In next sessions and onward, we will discuss some more things, more questions on parabola, and more concept on parabola. Apart from deriving the equation of parabola, this is completed. If you are unable to solve questions on the basis of what the concept I have given, you must write to us or ask to us if there any other situations are given and you are not able to derive the equation of parabola. But if you watch all this video till now, definitely you will be able to derive the equation of parabola very nicely and very comfortably. So enjoy, keep watching. That's all. Thank you. Thank you very much.